This is a Fox News alert. I'm Marianne Rafferty, live in Los Angeles. President Trump issuing dozens of final pardons and commutations as his time as chief executive dwindles to mere hours. Not surprisingly, the list includes Steve Bannon, Trump's former chief strategist. Bannon faces a federal case accusing him of defrauding donors of more than $1 million as part of a fundraising campaign purportedly aimed at supporting Trump's border wall. President Trump also granting clemency to former Detroit Mayor Kwame Kilpatrick, a Democrat. He resigned back in 2008 after being convicted of perjury and obstruction of justice. He's currently facing a 28-year prison sentence. Also receiving clemency, rappers Lil Wayne and Kodak Black, who were prosecuted on federal weapons offenses. The president, however, is not expected to issue pardons for himself or members of his family or his personal attorney, Rudy Giuliani. The former New York City mayor was at the forefront of unsuccessful efforts to get the results of the 2020 presidential election overturned. He also rallied with Trump supporters just before they stormed the Capitol building on January 6th. The possibility of pardons for the insurgents had reportedly been discussed, but almost everyone involved in those discussions aggressively advised the president not to. Trump has already pardoned a slew of longtime associates and supporters. They include his former campaign chairman, Paul Manafort, also Charles Kushner, the father of his son-in-law, and his longtime friend and advisor, Roger Stone. Also, his former national security advisor, Michael Flynn, and also on the list, four former Blackwater guards who were convicted of killing 14 Iraqi civilians. We're joined now on the phone with by Brad Blakeman, former deputy assistant to President George W. Bush. Brad, any names on this list surprising to you?
No, they really aren't. Look, presidential pardons and commutations of sentences are controversial by their very nature. If we look back in history, Barack Obama, in his 8 years, pardoned 148 and gave clemency to over 1,000. George Bush, George W. Bush, 189 pardons, 11 clemencies in commutations. And then Bill Clinton, 396 pardons and 61 commutations. So when you look at it in historical terms, Donald Trump falls way short of his predecessors in either granting pardons or commutations of sentences. Everyone will have their own opinion. The president has the ultimate power. And, you know, in a week's time, nobody will even remember this. But Bill Clinton pardoned a member of his family, his brother Roger, for drug offenses. And if we go back in history, we will see that as presidents leave office, they have a history of either pardoning or giving commutations of sentences to very controversial figures.
Brad, you know, also, I wanted to talk about the fact that it sounds like he was strongly discouraged from pardoning himself or anyone in his family. Talk about that and why that's important, something that he maybe should not have done.
Well, the reason being is when you grant a pardon, the person receiving it is basically admitting they've done something wrong. The question is, what has the president, if he were to do that, having to admit to that he did wrong in order to receive a pardon? So it's a double-edged sword. You know, it's never been done before. It could have been challenged, the ultimate authority of the president to do that. It would set a dangerous precedent if he were to do it. I think he made the right choice in not only himself but his family. I don't think there's any need to, and I think that's what the lawyers argued to the president, that if there's no need, why do it?
Yeah, you know, we're looking at the list that just came out of all the pardons that he did grant. A name that stands out that's not on the list, Julian Assange. That was a name that people were discussing as potential, you know, someone potentially he could pardon, but that looks like that did not happen. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, again, I think there was a lot of lobbying back and forth because that name was been floated before, and I think there were a lot of senators up on the Hill, including perhaps Mitch McConnell being the most vocal, that the president should not do that. And let's remember that the president is still in jeopardy and needs senators in his, especially Republicans, in his corner as we go into the next phase of impeachment, which is a removal trial in the Senate.
Anything else that stands out to you about some of these names on the list? Anything else that you think is important for people to note?
No, I think a lot of these names have been floated and it's been rumored for some time. I don't see anything on this list that is striking. I think tomorrow there's certainly going to be Monday morning quarterbacks who are going to speak either in favor of what the president has done or against what he's done. But again, the president is not unlike other presidents who, as they exit office, exercise their ultimate authority, which rests with the president to do these kinds of acts, either pardoning, forgiving crimes. And they're usually done for three reasons: humanitarian reasons, personal reasons, and politics. And people will opine on it, and then it will be just part of history.
Wow. So it seems as you're reading that list, those names that are on that list, they must be celebrating right now. A lot of these 11th hour pardons. What do you think those people are thinking right now as they're receiving the news that they've been pardoned?
Well, it is a huge relief, having been forgiven for crimes. Basically expunges the crime, but the record is that they had done something wrong, but there's no consequence anymore for those crimes. And same thing for, commutations of sentences. You still have the stain of a criminal conviction, but you're forgiven the time that you need to serve punishment. There's a reason why the founders did this, and giving the president this broad power to exercise as he sees fit for humanitarian, personal, or political reasons. And presidents have done it judiciously, some more than others, but not without controversy nonetheless.
So we're, just getting word of all these pardons. We've got 73 presidential pardons and 70 commuted sentences for a total of 143. Does that seem, I know we talked about this earlier, but does that seem pretty normal as far as presidential pardons go?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the president is right historically in the same category for his time in office as his predecessors. Bill Clinton, 396 pardons and 61 commutations of sentences, some very controversial figures, including domestic terrorists, his brother, and, of course, Mark Rich, who defrauded the government in his taxes. So every president faces the controversy of who he pardons and why he pardoned them or why he commuted a sentence. And again, everybody will have an opinion, but nobody can change what the president has done.
Brad, anything else that you want to add that you think is important?
No, I think that, again, tomorrow there will be a flood of experts who will either find fault or favor in what the president has done. I would urge people to read about the factual information behind what the president has done before they form an opinion. But the president this is less than 1% of the total number of applications that the president has received, over 10,000 in his term of office. So it's a power that all presidents exercise judiciously.
How about the pardoning of Steve Bannon? Was that a surprise, or is that something that should have been expected?
You know, it was a surprise to me. Bannon has been less than helpful at times to the president, yet the president found mercy in what Steve Bannon had been faced with. And, Steve Bannon, of course, was indicted, but he hadn't been tried yet. So this should be a big relief to Steve Bannon, and it shows that the president remembers the good that people have done and not necessarily the bad.
So does this presidential pardon then mean that everything goes away for Steve Bannon? I mean, that it's as if it never happened?
Correct. The pardon excuses federal crimes and expunges the record, but the fact is that Steve Bannon had done something wrong in order to receive a pardon. and with a commutation of a sentence, the record still stands of the criminality, but the forgiveness is in the time needed to be served.
Got it. And one last thing I wanted to ask, and not sure if you're familiar with this name, but there was a name being thrown around, the Tiger King, and we were told that possibly he was standing by waiting to find out if he was on this list, and it does not look like he is on there. Joe Exotic, you see him right there. Is that a surprise to you?
No, I think, again, it's going to be interesting to see what the president says, if anything, beyond the actions he's taken. So people may have to read between the lines to figure out why some people were pardoned or given commutations of sentences while others were not. But it's purely speculation because only the president knows.
Yeah, all right. Yes, that is true. We just got this list a few minutes ago. Brad Blakeman, thank you so much for all your insight into these pardons. We appreciate you joining us. Brad Blakeman, former deputy assistant to President George W. Bush. Thank you. And if you're just joining us, President Trump just issuing dozens of pardons and commutations. They included his former chief strategist, Steve Bannon, among other notable names that were not unexpected. We will have more on this as the day goes on.